It's visible. Screen is not visible yet. No. Someone saying no. Now it will take a bit time. Now it's visible. All of you are saying no.
No.
Not yet. Not yet. Wait. I'll again share it because in between I went for something else, and this may be because there things are very complicated. Remember this. We have to be habituated to internet system properly, and we have to understand it very clearly, otherwise you won't be troubled. So yes, now I'm presenting it. You can exactly see what I'm saying. Things are visible to you. You can see that. Now is it visible? You can see me also, because I'm in the screen. You can see me. Yes sir, yes sir. My speaker is on. I can hear you very clearly. Just switch on the mic and see me. Yes sir, it's visible.
Yes sir.
Fine.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Fine.
Yes sir. Yes.
Now, once we talk about, we are now into chapter 2 that we are talking. I'll switch off my video actually. I think I forgot to do that, because data consumption will be more in that case, so it's better to switch off the video. Yes, I've done it. So let's come to the page. So we have seen chapter 2. Open your book and keep your copy nearby you, because without copy you cannot write anything, and things are gone is gone. Remember this. In video and live there's difference, otherwise we wouldn't have gone for live. We would have gone for just video and would have been happy with video. So video is not enough. Now in the book you can see we talk about force and pressure. The first thing we should know, force. And by this time I think so, I have uploaded the video, you have seen the video even, but even then I repeat, force. The first thing we'll do, force. What do you mean by saying force? When we say force, you can speak out, because if I change the page I'll be in trouble. You can just switch on the mic and say me. I'll be clearly listening to you whatever you will say. But if you give again pinch, then you know that's okay. Admit somebody wants to get it. Yes, that I have to do. Yes, some more wants to enter. Wait. Fine. Now we are doing force. Force is nothing but, if we want to know about force, this is an external agent. Remember all this. Force is an external agent. Suppose, say, let me give you some example in from real life. Suppose, say, there is a door. I gave you some example in video, if you remember. I prefer to give same video example. I have a door here. I want to give some force in this. I want to open this. This is closed now and there is handle. So I give some force outwards. This is inside of the room and that side is outside. So the door goes this side. That means it is fixed this side, so it is movable other parts, so I am making it move. So this is a force I am giving. So we call it this type of force, which is going away from the source, we call it push. We are giving push. Dhakka. In simple words, if we say in Bengali, if we say, it's giving dhakka. On the other hand, if I want to open the door, maybe the door is allowed to go outside, so I do it. If door is to be is allowed to come in, then I have to give a force in this direction. I'll change color to make you understand in a better way. So this is inward direction. This is also a force. So we call it pull. These two terms are very important for you. You must understand this. One is push, where the force is given away from the source. It is going away from you, that is source. You are the source. And pull, that is you are going, you are pulling it towards, giving force towards you, towards the source. You are the source. So fine, all things are okay, we are giving force and we can think, see things are moving. But one thing is very important. If you have a wall like this, suppose you have a fixed wall and you give a force, you give pull, you cannot pull wall because there is no handle. If there is some fixed handle in this or bracket in this, then you can pull it. Otherwise, no question of pulling a wall comes, arises. So you can give only push to a wall. When you give push to the wall, your energy, the energy you are giving is very less. So you cannot make the wall move. Wall remains where it is. You cannot do anything to the wall. If this is the case, in such circumstances, we call it what? We call it typically, what do we call it? Body is at rest, the wall is at rest. Hello? What name you entered? What name you came in? What name you are in? Tell me your name, please. Tell me your name. What name you have entered? Anik. Once you came and you went off, again ask me again to enter. Say, I have pressed the link again. Press the link again. Don't you know English? Can't you speak in English? Do it again. Do it again. I'm waiting you. You do it again right now. Do it again right now. Do it again. Stop presenting anything else. Don't do anything else. Sit comfortably. Anik is not here, I guess. Anik is not here, I guess. Anik is not here. And
sir, your voice is not clear.
My voice is not clear. Just a minute. I hope now it's clear.
Yes, sir.
It will be clear because I
switched. Yes, sir.
So it's better to surrender comfort in front of education, because knowledge is more important than comfort. Now let's come back to the page. Let me wait for him. He will come and we'll see how exactly things are happening. So we are discussing force. Suppose say you have the wall, and on the wall you cannot do anything. You cannot make it move at all. Once you cannot make it move, that is very simple for you. That means we are very clear that the body, the wall, is at rest. You cannot
sir,
make it.
My voice is very guilty.
Now it's okay. It's okay, I guess. Now.
Not clear.
Let me.
Sir, I can't hear you.
Now let me stop sharing this. You'll hear you clear me now.
Okay.
I'll stop sharing because you have seen the picture and you can imagine. Fine, you can imagine. Can you see the screen? Can you see the screen?
No, sir.
Fine. I have stopped there.
No, sir.
But images in your mind, you have drawn, I think,
no,
so what I was drawing there. So, if you push a wall, suppose say you are going to press a wall. When you press a wall, it's not going to move. That means, is it not that you are not giving force? You are giving force. So the main topic of the chapter is force and pressure. So we have to be very clear that we are talking about force, no doubt. But when you give force to something, it is not necessary that force will make something move. It's not necessary. It may or it might not. You may give force to something, but it might not move, depending on the force that is getting a reaction from. We'll discuss all these things in details later. But what are the topics we are going to discuss in this chapter is, first topic we'll know, rest and motion. You can see here in the line, you can see here we have in the book, in the left corner of your book, you can see rest and motion we first discuss. Then we'll discuss types of motion. Then we'll discuss motion of a simple pendulum, very interesting. Then scalar and vector quantities. We did this in live class if you remember, and uniform and non-uniform motion we discuss later. And then we talk about speed, velocity and acceleration, and that is very important for you. And then mass and weight. At the end we'll know mass and weight. This includes many topics actually. To start with, we'll start with force. But you remember, they mention in the chapter name force and pressure, and then yes, tell me, and motion.
Your voice is not clear.
My voice is not clear. Please hold it. I'll just share again the screen with you, because you'll get everything in record very clearly. Now let me share the screen, because let me show you the presentation that is more important, so you'll enjoy it. You'll understand it also very clearly. Now, some of you don't have book, so I am sharing book actually also in this. Now please type Y if you have seen the screen. I'll make out that you are clear with the, or you can verbally also say me, yes sir, we have seen the screen. I have no problem. Switch on the mic and just tell me. Fine? Is it clear? Is it clear? It will take a bit time. Is it clear now? It's visible? Fine. Now, Om Prakash is also, I don't know who is that child, I don't remember the name, is presenting something. You are no longer presenting. My presentation has gone down. Some of you are doing mischievous actions. Why you are doing like this? Sit idle and don't do anything. You don't know technology and you are creating problem for me. Is my screen visible to all? Please write yes.
Yes, sir.
Fine, fine. So let's start. Time is running out. You have limited time of your class. Fine. Now, in the screen, you can see.
No, sir.
What? No, sir. The screen is not visible. See, if you do something, it's visible to me. I have seen who has done what. Things are recorded, remember. Any mischievous action you do here unknowingly, that will create problem for you. Because things are recorded. I am presenting again. And if yes, then write W when you see the screen. Some of you don't have book, so I am helping you so that you can see the book properly, because that will help you. Remember this. Now write, type yes if you can, or say me verbally. I have no problem in that. You can say me also verbally, so it's visible or not visible, whatever it may be. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
So the book, this is first page of your second chapter, and we are discussing force. Somebody is trying to enter. Yes. Sir, principal sir is coming in. Now, you can see here in the page, in the book, you can see here very clearly, we are discussing force. So when we talk about force, what is happening? What is this? Yes, the book has gone actually. Let me make it undo, because, wait. Now, when you talk about the whiteboard is enough, you can understand this with whiteboard. Yes. So, if you see the force, we are giving a force in such a way that we are creating problem for our door. This is my door, and door is not moving. Or the wall around the door, if I give force to the wall, wall won't move. This is the wall. This is wall, and it's not moving. I'm giving force as much. So I can say this part is at rest. Not moving means rest. And this is a door. And when I'm giving force to this, this is moving away. So we can say this is in motion. This part is in motion when it's moving. So this is motion. When you call it motion, then obviously there's lots of difference. In simple words, if you want to know motion, we can say one thing. If you have a distance like this, suppose say, and I have point, say suppose this is my Tarapur and this is Rangirkhari. I mentioned two places very carefully. This is Tarapur and this is Rangirkhari. And two of you have started, maybe one somebody's name is X and somebody's name is Y, and two of you starts moving, and we are there to look after the time you have started. Over phone we come to know that you started at 10 o'clock. Please listen carefully, there will be lots of numericals in this. 10 a.m. we started from, X and Y both started at 10 a.m. and this is the distance, maybe 3 kilometers, suppose say 3 kilometers, and here X reaches here at 10:30 and Y reaches here 10:45. So by looking to the number, you can say Y reaches 15 minutes later than X. Now with your common sense, distance is same, only time is difference. So how much time X has taken? X has taken time to be equal to 10:30 minus 10 o'clock. So 30 minutes. 10. I'm doing in a row way. So in numericals you won't do like this, but this is 30 minutes. Separately you can write 30 minutes. Similarly, Y has taken 45 minutes, you can say, for same distance. So we can actually find out what is motion. Motion is always with reference to something. On what basis I am saying that X is moving from Tarapur to Rangirkhari? Because there is a frame. We always refer to something with which we say it's moving. When you start from Silchar in a train, suppose say, we know first we have platform. Well, how you know that we are moving forward? First we have platform, and our train is standing here. The train starts moving in this direction, and after some time we find we are out of the platform and some houses are there, and we know, okay, fine, we are out of this platform. But remember, if there is nothing, no reference in the outside, then you are in trouble. You don't know actually you are moving. Best example I'll give you, inside the flight, when flight is moving, you see the window and there is no cloud, nothing. You don't feel that things are moving. Maybe flight is moving with 230 kilometers or 250 kilometers per hour, very high speed, but you don't feel anything. If it is cloud surrounded, then also cloud doesn't have any changes. So there is no reference with the outside. And inside you find everything is stable. Your chair is here, your first chair is here, your next chair is here, everything is stable. And the air hostesses are moving here in the corridor, so they don't move according to the outside structures. So for you, everything is standstill, rest. So you say something to be in motion. That is moral summary of this chapter, what I'm discussing now. That we claim something to be in motion if and only if with reference we see things are changing. For example, another example, very nice real day to live example I'll give you. Sunrise. We see the east horizon. Early in the morning we see sunrise. Fine. Then we see sun is moving, and by evening, afternoon hours, we can see sun is going to set, and that is in west. If this is our east, this is our west. In ancient days, people thought sun is revolving around.
Sorry, your voice is breaking.
Can you hear me now? Please try to listen, because when I upload the video, you'll get clear picture, clear sound, everything will be clear. So try to cooperate with me, because the whiteboard you are seeing, that is very important for you now, because I cannot show you without that. So when you have east, so people used to think sun is revolving around earth. Of course, in ancient India, we had thousands of years back, they very simply said we are revolving around earth, is revolving around sun. We never said sun is revolving around earth. And they also said very clearly moon is revolving around earth, because they said in the Sanskrit sloka that says moon is evolved from earth, it's daughter of earth. And Pacific Ocean, now science says this, physics clearly mentions this, that Pacific Ocean we have, that area, that land is being extracted out as moon. and that is such a big ocean now, because it's empty now. Anyway, these are different topics. We'll somehow, some other day, we'll discuss all this. Now, that means if you have some reference, something is moving, we call the body is at motion. Otherwise, it appears to us everything is at rest. So inside the plane, if the plane is moving very fast, even then you feel you are at rest. Just imagine, you know the formula in junior classes you have done, speed is equal to distance by time. Distance by time. So think about the speed of the flight. Time from Silchar to Kolkata, it takes here, I'm recording the time, 1 hour, about one, little less than 1 hour. 1 hour includes everything. Let me take then to be also 1 hour. And distance is about our speed, we know distance we can find out, and speed also we can find out. Distance is about 700-800 kilometers aerial distance direct. So this is by 800 kilometers, so the speed is 800 kilometers per hour. If you go by that, very tough, very high speed, it's not matter of joke. 800 kilometers per hour, it's very fast moving. So imagine in 1 hour, it can cover 800 kilometers. Another critical question I'll ask you now, because you have to be very conscious. This is a very critical question. Listen to me carefully and consider this assignment. Next day I'll ask you a question and you are going to answer me. For example, this is Delhi. Let me clean the board and say you this question. This is a very critical question. Listen carefully and then answer me. Right? Now, this is Delhi. Suppose, say, this is Delhi in Indian map. This is Kolkata and this is Silchar, somewhere here. If I come from directly from Calcutta to Delhi, Delhi to Calcutta takes 2 hours only in flight. But Silchar and Kolkata, which is very nearby, it's not so far off, I have not drawn properly, it takes 1 hour. My question is this: for such a long distance, it's about 1500 kilometers aerially from Delhi to Kolkata, it takes about 2 hours, but from Kolkata to Silchar, it's only about aerially 500 kilometers. I have said 800 was too big, 500 kilometers, it takes 1 hour. Why it is not more faster than this? It should have been faster because it's very nearby and this is very high distance, 1500 kilometers, and this is just 5500 kilometers. Think about Dubai is somewhat here. Dubai is further, much more off. Delhi to Dubai is taking just 5 hours. From Kolkata also it takes 5 hours. And answer my question, listen carefully and answer my question. From Calcutta Delhi also it takes, Calcutta Dubai also take 5 hours, Delhi Dubai also take 5 hours. Why? How come Delhi Silchar takes 2 hours, Delhi Kolkata takes 2 hours, and Kolkata Silchar takes 1 hour, where distance is just 1500 in Delhi Kolkata and this is just 500. Whenever you think about the answer, next day I want the answer of this assignment. This is an assignment, consider this to be assignment. A tricky question, and you have to handle it with your thought process. Things won't be available in book, let me tell you. A typical question answer type question is not this. You have to handle it very carefully. Now let's come back to our main topic. Back to main topic, force we are discussing. When you talk about force, we know that we are talking about motion indirectly. So two things we have come up with. One is motion, other is rest. And one thing is very sure, for these two terms, a reference point has to be taken for motion and also for rest. Reference point has to be taken. Jumi Miss is about to enter, so I think so. I have to stop the class. See how time runs out. It's very tough to run, and if you create, some of you in the beginning have been trying to present something, don't do anything, sit comfortably. We are struggling. Remember this. We are struggling here. It is not that we are doing fun. Because if you don't do it, your life will be totally spoiled. So be alert. Be in uniform and come in uniform always. And listen everything very carefully. I could do only today motion and rest. Some of you are saying my voice is not clear, and next time you are saying clear. These are accepted, but I will also upload this video where you get my sound very clear, even the picture will be very clear, and things will be already clear to you by that time. Thank you so much. Ma'am will take over now. I think Sujumi Miss is already here and she will take over. And so be there alert. And from tomorrow, I want uniform compulsory for everyone. Make sure you are in uniform. And if possible, change your name ID as your name. Like some of the students has done it, and that's very easy actually to understand. Otherwise, it becomes tough for us to estimate who is what. Fine. So thank you so much. Bye.
Thank you, sir.